In this video, we'll take a look at how to construct a frequency distribution table. Frequency distribution tables are used for quickly summarizing or tabulating a number of different values. We'll take a look at how to create a frequency distribution table next. Suppose we have the following values with scores for 20 people on the variable x, as you see here. Here we'll make a table where we'll tabulate or count the frequency of each value of x. First, let's look at the different possible values of x that we have in our data set. So here's our values once again. Notice above we have the values of x of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's take a look at that. So here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then these remaining numbers just repeat 1 through 5, right? There's no other values. There's no 6 or 7 or what have you. So we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the values occur multiple times. So we'll start our table with these 5 possible values, and we'll start with the largest value first, which is the typical way of constructing a frequency distribution table. So as our first step, we're going to begin by making a column in the table for x. And we'll start with the value of 5, and then we'll work our way down through all possible values ending in an x of 1. So here we've listed all the possible values that occur for our variable here. So we have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, just like we saw before. Then next here, we'll need to make a column for f, which represents the frequency, or the number of times each value occurs. We'll count the number of times each value occurs, and then we'll list it in the table under f, or frequency. So for example, notice here that we have 1, 2 ones, 3, 4, 4 ones in total for this variable, right? So we'll count the number of times each value occurs. Let's do another one. We have 2, 2, we have 3 twos, 4 twos, 5 twos, 6 twos. These, assuming I've done this correctly, I saw 4 ones and 6 twos. So we'll make this table here. Remember our x column before. Now we have this column f, as I had indicated earlier, and we list the number of times each value occurs. So remember how we had 4 ones? Notice here we have a 4 here under f for an x of 1. So this means we have 4 values of 1 for our variable. Okay? Or in other words, we have a frequency of 4 for x1, the score of 1. We have 6 values, as we counted, for a score of 2. Here we have 5 threes, 3 fours, and 2 fives. And that's really all there is to it. So in this frequency distribution table, once we have our values summarized, there's some advantages here. As opposed to when the values were all listed out like this, with our table, we can now draw some quick conclusions about the data that we couldn't before. For example, which value here occurs the most often? Well, for that, we would look under F, or frequency, and notice here the value of 6 is the largest in this column. So that means that the x of 2 occurred the most often in this data set, as it occurred 6 times. So another way to say this is the mode is equal to 2. Now, this is important here. I've seen a lot of people get confused with these two columns, and I completely understand how that can happen. So it's important to remember that this corresponds to the frequency, or it counts how many times a given value occurred. So sometimes when I ask for the mode, what someone will do is they'll say, the mode is 6. But the mode isn't 6 here. The mode is a value of 2, as the 2 occurred 6 times. Okay, so it's important to keep these two columns straight, so you always remember that this indicates the frequency, or the count, how many times a given value occurred. So 2 occurred the most often, at 6 times. Which value occurred the second most often? We see that's a 3 here, right? It occurred 5 times. And then the value that occurred the least often is what? A value of 5, right? As it occurred twice. So the x of 5 occurred 2 times. Its frequency was 2. Okay, so constructing this table allowed us to quickly summarize or organize our information for our variable, which is really one of the goals of descriptive statistics. So these tables can be quite helpful in quickly seeing patterns of data, the modal value, and so on. Okay, that's it for creating frequency distribution tables. Thanks for watching.